Why is Bill Gates running everything? Why does he get to decide that? You know, Bill Gates, I want to remind everyone, he wants to grow fake meat in a petri dish. And he wants us to drink poop water. So I don't know why we're letting Bill Gates decide our health decisions. But here's the deal. Bill Gates is very concerned about monkeypox because this is something apparently he can make a lot of money off of, and him and his other buddies. That is disgusting. And it is terrifying. Nasty, horrible, big bubbles of pus on your skin. I mean, clearly nobody wants this. So they're going to have pictures of all of these kind of terrifying images. They're going to show children with this all over their faces. And of course, they're going to be from, I don't know where they're going to be from. And then they're going to tell you, you have to wear a mask from, because if you get close to anyone's face and they spit on you, you're going to contract this horrible, terrifying disease, monkeypox. But don't worry, you got to go ahead. I know you have a Dr. Fauci pillow that you sleep with every night. We need to order your Bill Gates pillow. You should have a body pillow of Bill Gates, and you can cuddle with it every night because Bill Gates is going to save the day.
I just want to remind everyone, in case you've forgotten, that she is still technically a congresswoman. Like, she obviously just wants to do a right-wing podcast. I mean, that's what they all want to do. That's why Madison Cawthorn, Ted Cruz, has got his little podcast. They don't want to actually legislate. They just want to do this thing. But she's talking about like the pus and the pillows and trying to give her audience what they want. But she's supposed to be a congresswoman, Francesca. And here she is trying to scare people preemptively into, I don't know, being terrified of monkeypox on the one hand, and also trying to make you believe that it's nothing to worry about. Like, simultaneously, it doesn't have anything to do with Bill Gates. He didn't make monkeypox. It's been around before Bill Gates existed.
Look, first of all, Marjorie Taylor Greene is the pus-filled boil of Congress. So she understands this disease better than anyone. But I love the future that we're staring down of like, hell yeah, get monkeypox to own the libs. You know, be an unapproachable, smelly, nasty, like just, you know, pus-filled, ridden MAGA stan to own the libs. We're owned, man. Do it. I don't care. Like, throw your little monkeypox parties where you like get a chimpanzee drunk and then you all try to get it, you know, in whatever ways we won't ask about. But like, that's where we're headed. Is any amount, and again, it is funny, but it's also really sad because it has a lot to do with the fact that the healthcare system in this country is so inaccessible and so opaque to so many people because they don't have their doctor that they see regularly, or they are taught and always avoid the doctor. And while that's usually been for monetary reasons, now I think in this day and age, in a day of pandemics and vaccines, and misinformation, it's all about like, well, I don't know what they do anyway. I don't even know what medicine is. What about my supplement, right? So it's conflated, and totally, we are the perfect rubes in this country for this kind of medical misinformation.
I just want you to think that all of a sudden the entire population is steadily turning gay or turning trans, just generation. Probably in about 4 or 5 generations, no one will be straight anymore. Everyone will be either gay or trans or non-conforming or whatever the list of 50 or 60 different options there are.
In your, like, mind, where's that last generation coming from? I don't even understand what she thinks of the science there, but apparently, JR, as we launch into Pride, there are they that want you to believe that everyone is gay. And I don't know if she, what is the conspiracy theory here? That they want you to think that everyone's gay, which is not true in her mind. No, almost nobody is gay, but they want you to think that they're all gay. Or is it that they want you to think that they're gay and they are actually turning everyone gay? That people are being, against their will, converted into being gay or bisexual or polyamorous or asexual, or I don't know, I had a conversation with the wrong person and now I'm trans. Like, is that the conspiracy theory? I really shouldn't have had that conversation because now I gotta rethink everything.
You were here. It doesn't have to make sense, John. It has to scare people. There's this new nugget in these people's heads now that goes, oh my God, the gays are gonna take over. That's the fear.
I've got a question for you. How do you get avid gun owners and people that support the Second Amendment to give up their guns and go along with anti-gun legislation? How do you do that? Maybe you accomplish that by performing a mass shooting into a crowd that is very likely to be conservative, very likely to vote Republican, very likely to be Trump supporters, very likely to be pro-Second Amendment, and very likely to own guns. You make them scared, you make them victims, and you change their mindset, and then possibly you can pass anti-gun legislation. Is that what happened in Las Vegas? Is that why the country music festival was targeted? Because those would be the people, would be the ones that we would relate to? Are they trying to terrorize our mindset and change our minds on the Second Amendment? Is that what's going on here? I have a lot of questions about that. I don't believe Stephen Paddock was a lone wolf. I don't believe that he pulled this off all by himself. And I know most of you don't either. So I am really wondering if there is there's a bigger motive there. And does it have to do with the Second Amendment? Because what's the best way to control the people? You have to take away their guns. So that's just my question today. This is Marjorie Greene with American Truth Seekers.
So that was sheer madness. It's also a reminder, by the way, that up until when she got in elected office, she did not call herself Marjorie Taylor Greene. She called herself Marjorie Greene. It's just branding. That's why I have not participated in it. But anyway, I was watching in real time as the video was playing of our chat of people realizing what she was saying. Yes, she was implying that one of the worst mass shootings in the history of the United States in Las Vegas, where dozens of people were killed and literally hundreds of people were injured, was a government plot to take away your Second Amendment rights. And they've said that this, of course, after virtually every mass shooting. It never actually happens that they then get the guns taken away, but for some reason they think that the US government just keeps doing these false flags and then not capitalizing on it. I don't understand why. But what she was saying there is every bit as crazy as what Alex Jones has said about Sandy Hook and any number of other attacks. And yet she remains in office. She got popular. She got a name for herself, Farron, by spreading BS like that.
Yeah, and you know, I guess obviously after the false flag event, the Democrats are too busy patting themselves on the back for pulling it off successfully to remember that, oh God, we gotta take the guns now. Dang it, we forgot. Now I guess we gotta do another one. We were distracted. It's so dumb as to be laughable, except the fact that plenty of people believe it. Like, that's what's so terrifying. Actually, a friend of mine was at that festival in Las Vegas, in the crowd. And, you know, she posted this big long thing on social media a day or two after it happened, telling her story about, you know, just the sheer panic and confusion, just everybody hopping into cars, not even caring whose it was. People driving didn't care, just get in, taking them away, and just how nobody knew each other, but for a few minutes, like, they were the closest people in the world to you and you would do anything. It was a horrifying experience that she has written about several times since then. Wow. And for her to come out and say this is a false flag, this is somehow the government's plan to take your money away, absolute trash on every level. And I know that video is a couple of years old, but trust me, I've seen what she's been saying about, you know, the Texas shooting. It's not much better.